And welcome to The Watchmen. Folks, we have a lot to share with you today. We had the horrific ISIS terror attack in Manchester, England recently, and we also had Christians, yet again, targeted and killed by ISIS in Egypt. We're going to discuss all of that in a minute. We live in perilous times, and it's for such a time as this that Christians United for Israel was born. That's why we want to start out today with a very important announcement. It's just been confirmed that Vice President Mike Pence will be the keynote speaker at our annual CUFI Summit in Washington, D.C. on July 17th and 18th. Our team at CUFI is honored that the Vice President will address thousands of pro-Israel Christians who will come to the nation's capital to declare for Zion's sake, we will not remain silent. Now, we want you to be a part of this historic event. You see the information there on your screen. You can register to see Vice President Mike Pence live and in person at the CUFI Summit for the special Watchman discount rate of only $75. Not bad. Time is short, and July is just around the corner, so hurry up and register. Come to Washington, D.C. and make your voice heard. Make a difference for Israel and for America. Now, speaking of D.C., Vice President Pence recently hosted a special Israel Independence Day event at the White House. I was honored to attend this intimate gathering along with CUFI's founder and chairman, Pastor John Hagee, and other CUFI leaders. And I had the chance to catch up with Pastor Hagee afterwards and get his thoughts on the big news that Vice President Mike Pence will be the keynote speaker at the CUFI Summit in July. Pastor Hagee, we have an announcement regarding Vice President Pence and our 2017 CUFI Summit on July 17th and 18th. Pastor, what can you tell us?
Just a few days ago, Don and I were privileged to meet the Vice President personally in the West Wing. We asked him if he would be the keynote speaker for Christians United for Israel National Summit here in Washington, D.C., July 17th and 18th. And the Vice President has very graciously consented to be our keynote speaker. July the 17th is going to be the greatest Christian rally in Washington, D.C., and we urge the members of the body of Christ, all who support Israel and those who don't, to show up to demonstrate to this new Congress and to this new national leadership that the core of Christianity is pro-Israel and pro-Bible.
Yeah, folks, I can tell you, Pastor Hagee and I are standing in front of the White House. You probably wouldn't have seen us here in the past 8 years, to say the least, but it is a new day now under the Trump administration. And Pastor, if you can, we just saw Vice President Pence speak from his heart about his love for Israel, his love for the Jewish people. He's motivated by his strong Christian faith. Pastor, talk a little bit more about Vice President Pence, if you can, and the event we just attended here at the White House.
Sure. Christians United for Israel sent Vice President Pence and his family to Israel in 2014, and they came back lovers of Israel. He is a devout believer. He is a dedicated man of God. It's time for the body of Christ to recognize there's a new day in Washington. There's a pro-Israel leadership that we've never had in a long, long time.
Vice President Pence will be joined at the CUFI Summit by top leaders and experts like Ambassador John Bolton, White House Advisor Sebastian Gorka, Israel's Ambassador to the U.S. Ron Dermer, Pastor John Hagee, yours truly The Watchman, and many more. So go ahead and register and do not miss this historic event. Now, one of the big topics of conversation at the summit will undoubtedly be the ISIS threat. An ISIS suicide bomber recently massacred 22 people outside of a concert in Manchester, England, including an 8-year-old girl. This terrorist deliberately targeted young children. Think about that. A few days after Manchester, we had another ISIS atrocity, this time in Egypt. 29 Coptic Christians were pulled off a church bus and shot in cold blood by ISIS gunmen. The terrorists demanded that these brave men and women renounce Jesus. They refused and were killed, with young children again among the dead, martyrs for the Lord.